Now, everybody knows that the Black Swan photo is the latest Flat Earth mantra, but I'm not going to be doing a video on this photograph. So I'm going to take a look at a couple of photographs that are white swans, because Flat Earthers are under the delusion that since they've seen a Black Swan, then white swans no longer exist. Now, this is really a debate about horizons, and this is not rocket science. On a globe Earth, the horizon can be in front of objects, and the horizon can therefore be an obstruction that hides the bottom of distant objects. On a flat Earth, the horizon forms beyond objects. Therefore, the horizon is not an obstruction. Now, before I go on, I just want to let everybody know that this is a certified Nathan Oakley free video, so you don't need to run and grab a face mask to avoid spittle flying out of your monitor as he goes into one of his rants. So I'm going to use two videos by a flat earther, and I believe her name is Sandra. She has two channels, P1000 Cool Pics and another one, P900 Cool Pics. But she is like ranty flat earth. She actually has a lot of globe evidence. So let's take a look at this one, Blackpool to Isle of Man, 65 plus miles. Notice that there is an inferior melange in here, but also take a look at some of these wind turbines in the distance. So here's the screenshot, and the white arrows are pointing to turbines where the blades are actually cutting into the water. And here's another screenshot, the same thing. And the yellow arrows are pointing to where we only see a blade above the water. That means everything from the hub down is not visible. Now, if you're a glober, you look at this and it's just common sense. Well, this is evidence of curvature. But for a flat earther, this is anything but curvature. So let's take a look at some of their reasoning. So one of their excuses will be an inferior mirage, and it's easy to see it right in this section through here. But look how skinny this inferior mirage is. How is it hiding everything that we don't see of these wind turbines in the background? How do flat earthers come to the conclusion that this is a legitimate argument? You can even take one of these full-size wind turbines in the foreground, scale it down so it matches the size of that wind turbine in the background, and show that this mirage is clearly not thick enough to hide everything you don't see. And they still don't get it. In fact, Ranny Flat Earth has a video on his channel called "The Boat Didn't Go Over the Horizon." Well, here is a screenshot of that video. Here is the boat in the distance. Now we can clearly see that, yes, there is an inferior mirage, and we can clearly see that this is how thick that inferior mirage is. And here's a screenshot of that boat from the beginning of the video. I mean, how difficult is it to understand that this skinny mirage is not thick enough to hide all of this boat here? And what if there is no inferior mirage? Well, then it is waves. And the funniest part is you can see the waves in the video. They aren't that big. In fact, when they pan out, what do you see typically? 1 or 2 foot waves breaking on the shore. It just makes no sense at all. I've even heard of tides being an excuse for this. Do they really understand how tides work? Yes, a high tide is going to be higher on this mast than a low tide, but it's going to do it equally on all of these wind turbines. It's not going to bury these ones in the background up to their hubs. And another question is if you believe that water has found its level, then why do we even have tides? Seems like the water's been trying to find its level for thousands upon thousands of years and just quite hasn't done it yet. And of course, what is the flat Earth excuse without perspective being thrown into the mix? Now, flat earthers will use any of these terms to explain how this works. But as far as I'm concerned, this is where they turn perspective into flirspective. So this one is called angular resolution limits of your eyes. And it starts off with some good science. We see a boy here that is the same actual size, and as he gets farther in distance from the observer, we can clearly see that the angular size does get smaller. But it is important to notice that both the top and the bottom half of the boy reduce in size proportionally. But flat earthers have another idea once that object reaches the horizon, because now the horizon starts going higher and higher and higher, and the object starts disappearing from the bottom up. So you could have a situation like this, where you see a building in the distance, the top half is visible, the bottom half is not visible. And would they say, well, this is hidden by the horizon? Of course not. Nope, they are convinced that this building disappearing from the bottom up is legitimate science, even though right now the top half and the bottom half have the exact same angular size. And of course, this is one of those what the you know what moments. I mean, you really have to wonder if they think there's a row of Rayleigh criterion Pac-Men on the horizon that eat distant objects from the bottom up. So when it comes to the horizon, globers just trust what they see and use some common sense. But when it comes to flat earthers, well, it's anything but curvature. So let's take a look at another video by Sander. This is from her P900 Cool Pics channel. So what we're going to do in this one is we're going to take a look at how big the sun is here and compare it to the Isle of Man over here. Now we don't see any more of the Isle of Man to the right over here, so this must be North Barul. Now we know the sun is 0.53 degrees in angular size, and I am measuring its width this direction because we can see that the sun is flattening out, and this is not uncommon as it approaches the horizon. Next, I'm drawing a perfect circle around it so we can get a vertical measurement. Now I add a ruler that measures in tenths of a degree, and I scale it to the size of the sun. So the question is, what is the angular size of North Barul? So North Barul is 1,854 feet in elevation, or 0.35 miles. If we go to Google Earth, here's Cleveley's down here. Here is North Barul up here on the Isle of Man, 61.6 miles away. And since Mount Barul is quite far away, we can use this formula right here to calculate its angular size. And when we do the calculation, it comes out to 0.33 degrees. Now all I need to do is just take this ruler, drop it down to the horizon, so zero is aligned with the horizon, and this is 0.33 degrees. But in this photograph, North Barul is only about 0.06 degrees in angular size. But according to perspective and angular size, if the Earth was flat, Barul would be way up here. So again, this is evidence that most of North Barul is hidden by the horizon. And over here, we can even see a couple of the wind turbines that are below the horizon. So if we lived on a flat Earth, this is how big North Barul would appear to be when compared to the sun. But of course, we live on a globe. Most of that mountain is below the horizon, and therefore its angular size is much smaller. So sometimes we do have extreme atmospheric conditions that really distort what we see on the horizon, as shown by this example of a sunset, and as you can also see in the bottom two photos of the Falkland Islands here. But this is what we usually see. Objects in the background with their bottoms hidden by a clearly defined horizon in the foreground. So yes, black swans do exist, but white swans are much more common.